that the UK above all wants to see Zimbabwe succeed. We want to see it on that pathway towards a more prosperous scene on reforms in the last 2 years, and asked him to see what action he could take on that. But we also had a chance to talk about the humanitarian situation in the country and our concern that there are people who are food insecure, that there are people who are struggling with health, with education. And as the UK, we're providing £49 million for the food situation and a further £5 million to help prevent a cholera outbreak. We were able to talk about what we're doing, and I asked the Vice President please to share information about what the government is doing, about what's available in the grain stores, so we can coordinate our efforts in the interest of the Zimbabwean people.
And what was his take on that?
He said he's also very concerned about the situation, and in a very practical way organised a meeting with us in the coming days to share that information, and he'll be doing that with our head of DFID, Kate Turton, and we look forward to working in the future with him on that.
Anything about the Commonwealth?
We discussed the Commonwealth, and I said that from the beginning the UK has been very clear we would like to see Zimbabwe back in the Commonwealth, and at the point where the economic and political reform programme of the government has been completed and we have seen good progress on that, then that will be the time to look at membership. We are currently some way away from that, but we look forward into the future to seeing those reforms underway and for us to be able to discuss Commonwealth membership. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
For these and other stories, visit our website www.263chat.com. Follow us on Twitter @263chat and like our Facebook page, 263chat.